Good morning, legends. Welcome back to Northside TV.
Here's the latest edition of the Weekly Northerner for Friday, May 10th, 2024.
Don't forget this morning, there is a blood drive here at Northside. You must be at least 16 years old to donate blood. If you are under 18, you must have a signed parent consent form. If you have an appointment time to give blood today, make sure you get to the PO room early. Anyone who donates blood will receive a coupon for a free haircut at Sports Clips, as well as a free personal pan pizza from Pizza Hut.
The final senior meeting takes place next week. There will be two meetings on Thursday, May 16th, during third and seventh periods. They will both happen in the auditorium. Seniors will go to class first and will be called down over the PA system. Seniors who are currently on track to graduate will have commencement tickets waiting for them.
Prom weekend is only hours away. This year's prom is tomorrow night at the historic Embassy Theater from 8 to 11 p.m. This is your last day to purchase tickets, with cost $35 per person. All Northside students must have a valid school ID to purchase tickets. If you are eligible for redemption day tomorrow morning, make sure you are at school by 9 a.m. and can stay for the entire morning.
Attention staff, if you have not already, you will have to update your laptop to Windows 11 by the end of the day. Your computer must have at least 20 gigabytes of storage available to update it. The update will take a few hours to complete and needs to be done at the end of the school day while connected to the FWCS network. If you have any questions or concerns, contact Ms. Heichman, Ms. Bittner, or Ms. Smith.
Students, don't forget free math tutoring continues next week. Tutoring is available right after school in the college lounge. Math tutoring is every Monday and Wednesday from 2:30 to 3:30 in the college lounge. There are only a few more sessions left this school year, so make sure you take advantage of them before finals week.
The Northside Garden Club is still hard at work this spring with planting and preparing strawberries. The group will uproot some more strawberry plants that will be available this afternoon for students and staff. Anyone looking for some strawberries to plant can pick them up after school today in room E205. After receiving the strawberry plants, make sure you transplant them within 24 hours and water them well. When properly taken care of, they will keep coming back year after year.
Any student going on the 2025 trip to Paris and Amsterdam who is interested in additional fundraising opportunities should attend an after-school meeting next week. The meeting is on Wednesday, May 15th at 2:30 in room D326. Also, any students and staff who would like to go on the Europe trip next year can still sign up. There are informational Zoom meetings for the Europe trip on Wednesday evenings at 7. See Mr. Stanley in D326 for more information.
News from the clinic. Anyone with medications in the nurse's clinic needs to pick them up by the last day of school, which is Friday, May 24th. Any meds left in the clinic after that will be discarded. Also, all elevator passes need to be returned to the nurse, Sunny, before the last day of school to avoid a $25 fine.
Next week, the eSports team has a call-out meeting after school. The meeting is on Tuesday at 2:30 in room D242. If you're interested in playing for the team or casting the games on Twitch, come find out more. Now it's time for your weekly weather update with tonight's forecast and what you can expect over the next several days.
Scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms move across the region tonight into Saturday morning. Overnight lows drop down to the middle 40s. We have more rain chances in store for Saturday.
Tomorrow highs are expected to top out in the lower 60s. Mother's Day is looking dry and pleasant with afternoon highs reaching into the upper 60s and lower 70s.
The week ahead poses us with daily storm chances. High will reach the mid-70s and lows will get into the lower 50s.
And now for your Legends sports update.
Today, the baseball team is back on the road as they face off against Blackhawk Christian. First pitch is at 5:30. Also happening today, the Unified Track team will travel south for their next meet versus Norwell starting at 5:30.
Ninth and 10th graders on the boys track team will head up the road to Concordia for the freshman and sophomore relays. They will get started at 6.
Tomorrow morning, the baseball team hosts Concordia. First pitch is at Carrington Field, which is at 11. The JV baseball team is on the road as they face Bishop Lures. First pitch for JV is also at 11 a.m. Here's a look at what is happening next week for Northside Athletics. Next week, there will be a call-out meeting after school for all boys interested in playing soccer next fall. The meeting is on Thursday, May 16th, room E306. It will begin right after school, starting at 2:30. If you plan on playing for the team next season, you will need to attend this meeting to get all the information you need.
Any girls interested in joining the cross-country team in the fall are asked to see Coach Wanker for next week. If you like to run or are just interested in getting in good physical shape, then cross-country might be for you. Feel free to stop by B110 if you have any questions for Coach Wanker or would like to join the team.
Coming up, you'll hear from the latest 3D updates, Ms. Graham in the Media Center, a simple way you can help the environment, and much more.
Hi guys, welcome back to your Media Moment with Ms. Graham. This is our second to last Media Moment of the school year, so I have a couple of house wrap-up things to do. One is to say, if you have a library book that you've had since August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March, or April, please bring it back to us. We would love for all of our books to come back to us so that we can get them reshelved, and then we have to do inventory of all 23,000 books before the end of the school year. Does mean that the Media Center will be closing on May 17th. That means the whole last week of school, the Media Center will not be available to students except to return books. My hope is that we can get most of the books back before inventory starts though. So please help us out by doing that. I want to give a huge shout out to our freshmen who this year, so far, as of Thursday, May 7th, have checked out 3,692 books. You are killing it. The 10th graders are coming in second with 2,942. Let's hope we can get it to 3,000. That'd be really cool, 10th graders. 11th grade, 12th grade, you guys are way busy. You're in and out of the school. I understand. You even still managed to nearly get to the 11th grade, nearly got to 2,000. 12th graders are around 1,500-ish. You guys, I'm very proud of you for the reading that you've done this year. My hope is next year we can have even bigger numbers. The amount of books that were used in-house was way higher than last year too. So I'm hoping that every year we'll get more and more reading done, because reading really, really hugely impacts your academics as you move forward in life. You guys, it's my pleasure being your librarian. I'll see you next week.
Hello, I'm Jasmine Nichols.
I'm Josue Masasa.
And today is another round of sports trivia. Josh's first question is, what sport is best known as the king of sports? Your options are baseball, hockey, tennis, or soccer.
Soccer.
That is correct. And then your second question is, how many dimples does an average golf ball have? Your options are 241, 336, 317, or 283?
283.
Incorrect. The answer is 336. What's the national sport of Canada? Your options are lacrosse, cricket, rugby, or hockey?
Hockey.
The actual answer is lacrosse, which is surprising.
What?
That's what I'm saying. What do you call it when a bowler makes three strikes in a row? Your options are triple strike, spare, turkey, or sparrow?
Sparrow.
Incorrect.
Triple strike.
Incorrect. The answer is a turkey. Giving a little Thanksgiving, guys. What country has competed the most times in the Summer Olympics, yet hasn't won a gold medal? Your options are Tokyo, the Philippines, Russia, or Ukraine.
Ukraine.
Incorrect. The answer is actually the Philippines. Disappointing. And that's all.
I am Gabriel Shaheen, or Gabe, Northside grad. One of you led me back in the auditorium. I sat in one of those chairs, like you're sitting in. I sat at one of those desks, I listened to the teachers. And what I did was I decided to focus on and use what I was really good at. I was really good at math. And so I built a career using math. And the important part about that is that everybody is really good at something. It varies by person, right? But everybody's good at something. And you should know what you're good at. If you don't know what you're good at, ask your friends, because they know what you're good at. Everybody's good at something. And then well, for 23 years I worked for an insurance company after 5 years of college. Here's what I would do if I were you. I would want to learn as much as I can and stay as healthy as I can so that when I'm out of here, I can do what I want to do. I can live my life the way I want to live. You are preparing yourself for living your future life.
Good morning, Northside. I'm Lily Dugan.
I'm Opie.
And these are your prom 2024 court nominations. For junior girls, we have Brittany Monterazzo and Jesmaine Nichols.
For junior boys, we have Link Moorhead and Zach Spear.
And for your senior girls, we have Kaden Miller, Liberty Parker, and Dorothy Patty.
And for senior boys, we have Tyler Bennett, Giovanni Espinosa, and Nigel McFerrin.
If you have not yet bought your prom tickets, we strongly encourage you to do so.
And you vote for prom queen and king when you buy your tickets.
We'll see you tomorrow night at the embassy. Bye.
Hi. If you're watching this, I'm in the airport right now. Not everybody knows me, but my name is Ayamaiva Kanike. I'm an exchange student from Kyrgyzstan, and I spent my whole academic year at Northside High School. Video is about me saying thank you to every single person that I met during my exchange year at Northside High School, and I'm grateful for all people that spent time with me and just all people at Northside overall. I love Northside, and I spent the best year in my life in that school. So thank you so much. Enjoy the video. Love you guys. Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through. Then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. Talk about family when family's all that we got. Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride. It's been a long day. It's about you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it.
Okay, let's go. We'll
see you again. I've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it. When I see you
again. When I see you again. Like a germ. First you both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong and what's small. Turn to a friendship turn to a bond. And that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn. And that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone. How can we not talk about
everything?
Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you're gonna be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way. Every road you take. Each student at Northside matters, and I'm glad that I become a student of Northside High School, and I'm glad that I met all of you guys. Even if I don't know you, I love you, because Northside High School is the greatest impact that happened in my life. So I enjoyed my student years there. I'm just glad that I had this opportunity. Love you. See you next year, or not.
Hey Northside, welcome back to Staff 101. Today I'm going to be interviewing Mr. Opper. He's the new chemistry teacher, ICP teacher.
ICP.
At Northside. Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Okay, so this is my 23rd year teaching. Oh, wow. I taught at Angola for 21
years. I was at Northrop last year, and then I'm here at Northside this year. I have a daughter who's 14. She goes to East Noble Middle School. Mm-hmm. She's into cross country, track, swim, band, choir. I also work a second job. I work at a golf course that I've worked at for 20 years in Garrett.
How do you like
your second job? I like it. Yeah. They're challenging times, mm-hmm. like every school, but yeah, it's not much different than Northrop, to be honest with you. A little bit smaller.
Oh, yeah.
A lot different than Angola.
What do you mean?
A lot smaller.
Okay.
They only had like 900 students.
You like knew the same people all
Yes.
throughout?
Yes. Yes, I had some of the same kids for 4 years in a row. Yeah, because I taught all different kinds of science.
Did you prefer that, or did you like
This is still new enough that I don't know the answer to that.
Okay, cool. Now you got to switch it up a little.
Yeah.
Make life interesting.
Yeah.
Okay, tell me about, like, are you from here?
I am from Auburn.
Auburn, okay. So what high school?
I went to DeKalb.
DeKalb. Did you play any sports?
I was a band kid. I was in all the different types of band. Then I went to IU, got my bachelor's in biology, wanted to be a doctor, took the MCAT twice, did not do very well. My senior year, I switched to education, said, I'll try this for a few years, and it's 23 years later, and I'm still doing it.
You love it?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
good.
Yeah.
I was about to say, like, oh, man, you seem really smart. I'm surprised you didn't do. Did you ever think about going back to medicine? Or?
No.
No?
No. I'm That's too good. Old now.
I don't think you're too old. No, you got, like, a youthful spirit. What is your favorite show?
All time, Mythbusters.
Oh, I actually know that one.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I like that
show. I also like Big Bang Theory.
Oh, I love that show too. You look like a Big Bang Theory fan. Have you seen Young Sheldon?
I have.
You like it?
Every episode I've seen it, yes.
Oh my God. I'm like on season four. I'm about to get there.
My daughter's binge watching that right now.
Is she?
Yeah.
I think it's a good show. Yeah. It's like I think it's for all generations and like you can really relate to it. It's funny. You think it's dorky, but it's not. And like, yeah. Thank you so much for watching Staff 101. Tune in next week. Bye.
Yeah, for me, I would say it's Jay-Z, 99 Problems.
Thank you.
Always gonna be Drake.
Nourish, no pay, and Dream Girl.
Okay, thank you.
Probably going off 1700. So, flame out, new phone.
Going off 1700, free brick.
My baby, or sexy red. Yeah.
Zach Bryan.
Mine is probably Andre 3000.
I mean, usually I say Drake, but Kanye West.
I'm Ronnie Jones. I'm here with
Elijah.
Elijah, if you were to go on vacation for 1 week, where would you go?
Florida.
Florida? Okay. Thank you.
Mrs. Sanchez.
Where would you go on vacation for 1 week?
Somewhere warm, somewhere I haven't been. Probably the Bahamas or something.
What's the most favorite?
It's kind of hard. I think I would go to Brazil.
Brazil?
Yeah.
All right, thank you.
I don't even know, twin. Probably like Houston or somewhere, twin.
Thank you.
If you can go anywhere in the world for 1 week, where would it be?
Greece.
Dubai or something.
Dubai. All right, thank you. If you were to go on vacation for 1 week, where would you go?
The Bahamas.
Bahamas? Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks for tuning in. That's all for today's edition of the Weekly Northerner. We only have 2 more weeks of school left.
Have a great day, Legends. We'll see you here next week.